The Marcos Jr. administration anticipates over 100 billion pesos in fresh revenue from a newly signed law imposing a value-added tax on foreign digital service providers. We have this report. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Wednesday signed into law a measure that imposes a 12% tax on foreign digital service providers, such as Netflix, iTunes, Spotify, and HBO Go. The Philippine leader signed Republic Act 12023, or the Value-Added Tax on Digital Services Act, one of the administration's key priority measures, during a ceremony in Malacañang attended by government officials and lawmakers. The law covers digital services such as online search engines, cloud services, digital ads, e-market platforms, and digital goods. However, online courses, webinars, and other digital educational services will be considered VAT-exempt, as well as the services of banks and non-bank financial intermediaries. The government, however, clarifies the law does not impose new taxes, but instead strengthens the power of the Bureau of Internal Revenue to collect taxes on digital service providers or DSPs. It is also expected to level the playing field for local DSPs and their foreign counterparts. This is because before the enactment of the law, only DSPs based in the Philippines are required to pay the 12% VAT, while non-resident DSPs, or those that have no physical presence in the country, enjoy a tax advantage, even as they profit from Filipino consumers.
If you are reaping the rewards of a fruitful digital economy here, it is only right that you contribute also to its growth. After all, whether you are a small tech startup or a global tech giant based halfway around the world, if you are making money here in the Philippines, you are part of our community. And with that comes a shared responsibility.
The VAT on Digital Services Act is expected to generate over 105 billion pesos in revenues for the government in the next 5 years, 5% of which will be allocated to the local creative industries.
This means our artists, filmmakers, musicians, the very people who fill our platforms with stories and with content, will directly benefit. It ensures that our creative talents are not just surviving in a competitive digital market, but will be allowed to prosper. Fairness, inclusivity, and progress.
The Bureau of Internal Revenue, meanwhile, welcomed the enactment of the law. But should Filipino consumers now expect an increase in the prices of digital services?
So as to whether magkakaroon ng price increase, no, it doesn't necessarily follow. Of course, it would also depend on the it's a business decision by the service providers.
Meanwhile, Lumagi warned that non-compliant digital service providers may be suspended or blocked through the agency's online candado program. The BIR says it will start imposing the VAT on foreign DSPs 120 days after the effectivity of the laws implementing rules and regulations.